I learned that there were 5 TV channels and half of them were about proper etiquette in North Korea. They had their own music channel with their own North Korean music. So the citizens of North Korea aren't really exposed to anything from the outside world. I mean, there's no Wi-Fi, no cell phone service. You can get a cell phone, but it's not, yeah, there's no like AT&T, sir, which I did have in most countries. So you're pretty much removed from it all. And they don't really let you leave unless you're a tour guide, pretty much, or in the government. Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. I'm so glad to have you back here with me. I'm going to be sharing with you a 4-part series of my trip to North Korea back in 2016. Now I'm going to be jumping in and out between this clip and this other clip that I filmed that was very long. I said a lot of stuff in there that I wanted to say and I couldn't say it any better right now, so I'm just going to be popping in with that other clip and this one to just kind of tie everything together. This took a lot of work to create this video and a lot of interviews kind of stuff. So initially I was going to visit North Korea for my 28th birthday. I spent my 27th birthday in Mongolia and it was beautiful and amazing and tranquil and I had no Wi-Fi, I had no cell phone service. It was beautiful. But this birthday I wanted to spend it in North Korea because I am a strange person and I like to go to these places and I actually enjoy going to these places like North Korea, like Syria, like Somalia, Afghanistan. I actually enjoy it and I enjoy learning about those cultures and debunking what America has told us about those places for our whole lives and what makes us afraid to go to these places. I ended up not going on my 28th birthday. I think my trip got pushed back. I missed something happened, but I wasn't able to go.
Times have changed, but even back then, things were really difficult there and especially challenging for an American citizen to travel there alone, especially a female traveler traveling there solo. For some reason, people think that everything is always dangerous when a woman's traveling alone. And that is the case in some cases, but when it comes to North Korea, there were a lot of women traveling there solo from China, especially my tour group, and there were a lot of men traveling solo as well. So I'm gonna try and outline everything in regards to what I know and try and share with you my own experience. I think it's really, really important to note that I'm 30 years old, and despite having traveled to every country in the world, I want people to know that I'm not as educated as I could be in every single country of the world. I continue to make mistakes to this day. To really understand everything about a country, it requires a lifetime of living there, in my own opinion. I've tried to do as much research as possible with North Korea and sharing that element of North Korea with you, the side of statistics and data. Every single person has their own experience when they travel to a place, but I do want to say that overall my experience in North Korea was a good one and I would go back. I got quite a bit of backlash when I first traveled to North Korea. The general kind of consensus that I was hearing was that why would I go to North Korea and promote tourism there given the circumstances of what the citizens in North Korea are experiencing in regards to their government and being controlled and they're suffering and they're not getting any of that tourism money. I personally don't know the stats on that, but I can assume that the people and the citizens of North Korea are not benefiting at all from my tourism of going there as opposed to other countries. Tourism in general, positive, responsible tourism, is really important for a lot of countries around the world to put them on the map, to increase their economy, to shed light on the positive things about that country and also the negative things that can be changed, that need to be changed, so that people can help that country flourish for the better. So tourism is a really good thing. Okay, but when it comes to North Korea, when you travel there, the money is not benefiting the people, it's benefiting the government, and that government treats its citizens poorly and has for years and years and years. And also, their tourists that go there, they also treat poorly if you do anything wrong. So it's kind of a lose-lose for everyone. However, with that said, my goal throughout Expedition 196 was to promote the beauty of countries around the world, show the positivity, show that yes, it might be a dangerous place to go to, but the people, they have to live there. They have to breathe there. They have to survive in that country. And if they have to suffer, you know, and you have the opportunity to go there and help them in some way or raise awareness about an issue there or whatnot, then you should. Then I think if it's something you're passionate about and if you really care about specific countries around the world enough to want to travel there and share your experience with the world in hopes of shedding light on something negative or positive about that country, I think it's important. My goal personally was not sharing negative things about the countries I was in, is about sharing the positive elements of the countries that I was in. So for example, in Somalia, a really dangerous country to travel to, but I wanted to break through that and show that the people are really kind. They're so happy, and they just want to talk with you, and they're just really hospitable people in Mogadishu. And I wanted to show that there's a different side of Mogadishu that tourists can experience, not only just go there and live and travel in fear, but also experience the positive elements of Somalia. Same thing with Syria, same thing with Afghanistan. Every country that I went to, I tried to unleash some sort of positivity. And in North Korea, that was easy to do because, yes, I went on a tour. So when you go on a tour, especially in North Korea, they're going to show you all the positive things that they want you to see of that country, in that country. North Korea is known for offering its travelers and tourists these tours that show only specific areas and specific things about North Korea that they want them to see, that comes off as painting this really perfect picture. But when you travel on any tour in any country around the world, they want to show you what you have on that itinerary, and usually it's a good thing. Usually they want to show you the beauty of that country, the culture, the heritage, do an activity just to show you the positive elements of that country. North Korea, it's the same in regards to when you purchase a tour, they want you to experience the good things and the things that they have painted for you perfectly. While yes, I had a positive time in North Korea, in regards to tourism, I don't want to advocate tourism in North Korea. Any other country around the world, literally any other country but North Korea, I would say is worth visiting, and is worth visiting specifically to enhance their economy through your being there, through your tourism, through spending your money. It's benefiting their economy. When you go to a place even like Kabul, Afghanistan, you can actually buy from the locals on the street who are selling whatever it might be, jewelry, clothes, chicken, whatever it might be. You can directly support those people. In North Korea, there's no opportunity to directly support the people there. So when you pay for a tour, the money's going towards the tour agency and, who knows, the government, I'm assuming. With that said, I'm going to be completely open here and speaking for a lot of Americans and Westerners who travel into North Korea for their own sake, is that it's a selfish thing for anyone to want to travel into North Korea, because hear me out here. First of all, you're risking your life by going to North Korea. It's a risk as a Westerner to go in. I wouldn't say it's as much of a risk for the Chinese to enter North Korea. I know that there's a lot of Chinese that will take tourists to North Korea. It doesn't seem to be as much of an issue. And again, I didn't do heavy research on this or anything. I just was in a tour with a bunch of other Chinese tourists, and it was very easy for them to get in and out and no problems whatsoever. But when Westerners are seeking to travel to North Korea, this is why it's a selfish thing, because we just have to accept that. It's a precarious nation, which makes it exhilarating to want to see what's there and why it's so risky. So a lot of Westerners will want to travel there. They know they're risking their life, but they'd rather experience what is North Korea and what's it like, and can I get in and out safely? And there's this like allure, like this draw. And that's not such a good thing in a lot of cases, this one being one of them. There's so many ways for adventure travelers to pass away doing things that are really extreme. When you're an adventure traveler, you take risks, and sometimes they're not the smartest risks. Sometimes it's just based on luck. You never really know. So for those kind of thrill seekers who want to go to North Korea and experience getting in and out safely and experience what it's like there and maybe take a risk and do something crazy while there, break the rules and see if they can make it out. I traveled there selfishly. Want to experience North Korea to try and break my record. I also would have gone there anyways. I was about to go there last April for the Pyongyang Marathon, and I had registered to go and signed up and, you know, solidified the tour and everything. Then they let us know that Americans were having an issue coming back into the US from North Korea. So they could get into North Korea, get out of North Korea, but when it comes to going back into the States, entering through border control, they were having issues. We ended up canceling our trip, and oftentimes than not, I continue to think, well, I'd like to still go back and go skiing there. So yeah, selfishly, I wanted to go to North Korea, and I had to go to North Korea, and this is a big reason why I haven't really wanted to share a video on it or talk about it, because I don't want to advocate someone going to North Korea, because there's a lot that can happen by just making one wrong move, one little tiny mistake, and your life could be over, literally. And they're risking the lives of other people who might want to travel to North Korea. There's no way to really connect with the people there in regards to any other country. That's something that North Korea is really limiting with. You will see people, you'll drive by, you'll see them, you can interact with them, but there's no way to really connect with them. And once you leave, they leave you as well. There's no way to keep that connection because they just don't have access to the outside world. I honestly think it'd be difficult to meet friends there because the tours have you so constricted and constrained, you can't walk outside your hotel room even like more than 500 feet. So it's how are you able to even like meet people and friends and get to know the culture? So I will say that much. I'm not helping the people at all by going there. If I went there even on a humanitarian mission, it would end. First of all, I wouldn't be able to get into the country, let alone get out. And that's not something that the government condones. So even if I had the best intentions in mind to want to travel to North Korea for good, unselfish ways, it would just be next to impossible. possible. There are a lot of things in life that people do that are selfish and that aren't in the greater good for the world or a place or another person. Traveling to North Korea, I wouldn't recommend doing because you're not necessarily gonna get a whole lot out of it unless you want to just boast that you went to North Korea or unless you're really able to get like an immersion tour somehow. It's very important to understand this, and I did not understand this going in, and it wasn't until actually I was kind of getting shamed for having gone to North Korea that I educated myself on all this and was able to learn. It's fair to receive that criticism in order to learn. I know there's a lot of people who will continue to go to North Korea and not be educated on this. They'll just want to go and just because, you know, like I said, risky and exhilarating and different, the reasons why they shouldn't, they're not aware of. I would say probably the only country in the world where traveling to it won't benefit the people and won't really benefit you either, other than just having gone and seen something that they want to show you. I wish I knew how to help North Korea and how to help the people there, how to create a better world for them and a better environment for them to flourish and a way for them to travel and just like get out if they want to and have that communication with the outside world. I know that the people there have grown to learn what their country is and that's all they know, and they might be okay with that. Just like the less you know about other things, the more comfortable you are in your own place, I guess, the less you know, right? We see it how it is from the outside, what it's like there and how the people are being treated. You can just do a quick Google search on the citizens of North Korea and how they're treated by the government, and you can learn about it. Yeah, I wish they could all be free and experience this world and travel and live in peace and positivity and have that opportunity. Like so many countries around the world though, and especially women around the world who are conformed to living in a certain way, in a certain place and never leaving. There's a lot of issues like that around the world, but in North Korea, really no one has the opportunity to leave. I don't know how to help the situation other than to educate through this video. And I hope that my following videos will not make you especially want to go there. I'm trying to be as honest as possible and sharing my experience. And I don't want to say it was an awful time, it was an awful experience, because it wasn't. I am selfishly happy that I was able to go and that I went, and selfishly I would like to go again. But I hope that I don't send off the wrong message with my videos. I just hope that this gives you insight to North Korea. And at the end of the day, we all want to learn something new. We all want to see something new. We want to be entertained in some way. And with something that I had to do in order to break my Guinness World Record and going to North Korea, I just want to share my experience, and that's that. Just like anything else in life. Without further ado, I'd like to get started on this video series. I'm sorry this was a huge disclaimer video. I hope it was a little bit of education as well, but the next three videos will be much more interesting, I promise.